Hello everyone. Today, we aim to prove Euler's formula using two different methods. The first method involves using a differential equation, and the second method employs a simpler approach using derivatives. The formula we are going to prove is e to the power of I theta equals cosine theta plus I sine theta. If we denote the right side of the formula as z, then z equals cosine theta plus I sine theta. Now, let's differentiate both sides with respect to theta. The result is dz over d theta is d cosine theta plus I sine theta over d theta, which simplifies to minus sine theta plus I cosine theta. Rearranging these terms, we get I cosine theta minus sine theta. Factoring out I, we obtain I times cosine theta minus sine theta over I. To eliminate the I in the denominator, we multiply both the numerator and denominator by I. This yields I times cosine theta minus I sine theta over negative 1. And the reason the denominator becomes negative 1 is due to I squared being equal to negative 1. We can rewrite it as I times cosine theta plus I sine theta. And upon substituting back the expression we denoted as z, it becomes clear that I times z. This expression represents a differential equation, and we can solve it with separation of variables. To illustrate, consider a differential equation like dy over dx is x over y. If we rearrange it to have y terms on the left and x terms on the right, we get y dy is x dx. Integrating both sides results in the integral of y dy equaling the integral of x dx, making the integral separable. The solution to this equation after integration is y squared over 2 is x squared over 2 plus c. Through separation of variables, we can express y in terms of x. Applying a similar approach to our differential equation, we multiply both sides by d theta, yielding dz is iz d theta. To separate variables, we divide both sides by z, resulting in 1 over z times dz is I times d theta. And from here, we proceed with the integration on both sides. The integral of 1 over z is ln modulus z, and the right side becomes I times theta plus c1, where c1 is the constant of the integration. If we remove the logarithm, modulus z becomes e to the power of I theta plus c sub 1, and expressing the exponential function as the product of 2, we get e to the power of I theta times e to the power of c sub 1. Here, e to the power of c sub 1 is a constant value, so if we write it as c sub 2, then modulus z becomes c sub 2 times e to the power of I theta. Removing the absolute value, we have z is plus minus c sub 2 times e to the power of I theta. Since plus minus c sub 2 is ultimately an arbitrary constant, we can simply write this value as c. Considering it as an arbitrary constant, it can be positive or negative. Now, z is simply expressed as c times e to the power of I theta. Earlier, we denoted z as cosine theta plus I sine theta, and using this, we can find the value of c. If we substitute the simplest value, 0, for theta, then z is 1 plus 0, which is 1. Substituting the same values, theta is 0 and z is 1, into our left-hand side expression, we get 1 is c times e to the power of 0 is c, which ultimately leads to c is 1. Since c is not 1, z ultimately becomes e to the power of I theta, and thus, it is equivalent to cosine theta plus I sine theta. In this way, we have demonstrated Euler's formula using differential equations and initial condition. Now let's prove this formula using differentiation. First, let's write Euler's formula. Then, let's define a function of theta denoted as y, as e to the power of I theta over cosine theta plus I sine theta. Now, let's differentiate y with respect to theta using the quotient rule. The numerator becomes e to the power of I theta prime times cosine theta plus I sine theta minus e to the power of I theta times cosine theta plus I sine theta prime. And the denominator is cosine theta plus I sine theta squared. When we differentiate the terms in the numerator, we we get I times e to the power of I theta times cosine theta plus I sine theta minus e to the power of I theta times minus sine theta plus I cosine theta. And the denominator remains cosine theta plus I sine theta squared. Expanding the terms in the enumerator, we have I times e to the power of I theta times cosine theta minus e to the power of I theta times sine theta plus e to the power of I theta times sine theta minus I times e to the power of I theta times cosine theta. And the denominator remains unchanged. Upon expanding the numerator, as shown on the screen, we observe that all terms cancel out, resulting in 0. In other words, dy over theta over d theta is 0. What does this mean? To illustrate, if y is 4, then the derivative of dy over dx is 0. This indicates that the derivative of the constant is always 0, implying that y theta is a constant. Therefore, let's denote y of theta as an arbitrary constant c, where c is a real number and cannot be 0. At first, we defined y of theta as e to the power of I theta over cosine theta plus I sine theta. And to find the constant value of y over theta, we substitute theta with 0. Then cosine 0 is 1 and sine 0 is 0, so y of 0 is 1 over 1 plus 0, which is equal to 1. Since y of theta is always the same constant value of c, and we found that y of 0 is 1, the constant c is indeed 1. In summary, y of theta is 1, and consequently, e to the power of I theta over cosine theta plus I sine theta becomes 1 as well. Therefore, e to the power of I theta is cosine theta plus I sine theta. In today's video, we demonstrated Euler's formula using two different methods. There are also other approaches, such as using Taylor series to prove this formula. This channel has many areas for improvement, and if you have any suggestions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment. If you enjoyed the video, please consider subscribing and liking. Thanks for watching. I've been your math guardian, Alex.